Don't let your AC system get knocked down by the heat this upcoming summer. Call KS Services and let our team come take a look. We repair and install all makes and models. We even offer a free no-hassle quote and second opinion, so give us a call today. With our flexible financing, you can literally pick your payment. We may even be able to help you knock down that utility bill a bit.
KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.
It's the Weather Xtreme video. This is the afternoon edition. This is for Thursday, the 19th of July. I'm James Spann. Got some scattered storms in progress today. We could see some pretty rough activity as the weekend begins, late tomorrow night or early Saturday. A lot to talk about, so let's dive in and do it. Here we go. This is the upper air look across the country. We got a heat ridge off to the west. It's blazing hot out there again today. Troughing digging down across the northern plains. That'll be expanding down this way, giving some dynamic support to potential for severe storms tomorrow night or Saturday morning. But today, that's the situation at mid-afternoon, the visible satellite view. The northwest Alabama counties have cleared out. They started off the day with rain this morning, new storms forming on the outflow of the morning storms over east and southeast Alabama. That was the radar at 2:30. Showers and thunderstorms rather extensive south of a line from near Anniston down to Prattville and Selma. But again, the northwestern counties are stable and cool. 79 for Tuscaloosa. How about that for the 19th of July? Birmingham 83, low 90s for Anniston and Gadsden over on the eastern side of the state. Around the nation, looks like the peak of the heat is around Childress and Wichita Falls, Texas. It is blazing out there. Looks like they're up to about 110. But up north, nice and cool, low 70s over Minnesota and parts of the Great Lakes. Needless to say, we got excessive heat warnings out around Dallas-Fort Worth, Waco, Abilene, Tulsa. But things are quiet here. This is the severe weather outlook for the rest of today and tonight. A marginal risk around Memphis down to Jackson. The standard slight risk, including Kansas City, St. Louis, Little Rock, Des Moines. And then tomorrow, we have a risk of severe storms from the southern Great Lakes down into the deep south. This is the new revised day two outlook. And keep in mind, this includes tomorrow, tomorrow night, and early Saturday. This runs through 7 a.m. Saturday. We now have an enhanced risk of severe storms over parts of the Tennessee Valley, including Athens, Huntsville, Decatur, and the Shoals. The standard risk, level 2 out of 5, down to Tuscaloosa, Birmingham, and Anniston, and a marginal risk now as far south as Thomasville, Greenville, and Opelika. And we'll talk about this in more in just a moment. And then for day 3, after 7 a.m. Saturday, a marginal risk over the eastern counties of the state. Rain for the next 7 days, the east looking fairly wet. In Alabama, rain amounts lighter on the western side of the state. Heavier totals for southeast Alabama. This is suggesting Dothan might pick up 3 inches of rain. But, of course, we all know your number will probably vary because of the scattered nature of the storms. And the tropics, very quiet. A lot of dust, dry air across the deep tropics. So here we go. Let's take a look at the GFS. This is the 12Z run, valid tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock. Upper low around the Great Lakes. It'll give us some dynamic support. Down below that, a surface low near Milwaukee, 1,000 millibars. And during the day, I'm not so sure we see much activity. Let's look at the high-res NAM. This is valid tomorrow at 4, basically showing nothing. And if that's the case, we'll have a lot of sun. We'll be up in the 90s, and the air becomes very unstable. In fact, this is the projected instability tomorrow at 4 o'clock, and the peak is 5,200 joules per kilogram. And understand, in summer, we always have high values. But that's pretty robust for July, and those peak values are over West Tennessee and North Mississippi. Midnight. And let me just say this, too. The NAM and the models will struggle with these northwest flow events. Every run's going to look different. But this is midnight, 12 a.m. Saturday. It's got a batch of storms coming into the Tennessee Valley. Other storms trying to form on the western side of the state. Saturday at 5 a.m. The NAM has a batch of storms over the Tennessee Valley. Another batch coming down through Birmingham and Anniston. So, and again, exactly how this unfolds, we don't know that yet. But I think that's clear because of the instability and the dynamic support. The window's open for an organized batch of storms tomorrow night, early Saturday morning. I'd say the main window, maybe as early as 9 o'clock tomorrow night through 4, 5, 6 a.m. Saturday. The main threat, strong straight line winds. But if we see some supercells that try and form in here, there could be an isolated tornado. So we encourage everybody to kind of watch for warnings carefully and pay attention to severe thunderstorm warnings. These things could produce damaging straight line winds easily. We'll go to noon Saturday, and that looks just like some decaying showers, mainly over the southern half of the state. I think a decent part of the day Saturday will be dry after the stormy start early Saturday morning in the pre-dawn hours. Here's the synoptic scale look, the big scale look on Saturday. Saturday's high will likely be around 90, maybe low 90s if the sun breaks out for a while. This is Sunday. We're under a trough. Highs drop back in the 80s, and again, we'll have the chance of scattered showers and storms in an unstable atmosphere. And we're going to have that chance basically every day through next week. We'll go to Monday. This is Tuesday. Wednesday. Promise we're showing you different maps. They look the same. Every day, the sun out at times, and every day, a chance of showers and storms, highs in the 80s. And a week from today, this is Thursday the 26th, heat bubble way out west, a nice trough axis from the Great Lakes down into the deep south. And again, a moist air mass, showers and storms and scattered spots, highs in the 80s. No excessive heat problems here anytime soon. Let's go out 10 days, Sunday the 29th, and again, troughing from the Great Lakes south. A surface boundary approaching, and again, scattered showers and storms about, with highs probably in the 80s. Check the numbers here. Look at next week. Highs in the 80s and lows in the upper 60s and low 70s. Below average for this time of the year, and typically, this is about the time we get into the peak of the summertime heat. That's it for the Weather Xtreme video this afternoon. We'll have notes in the blog next video here by 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. If you can't catch us this evening, on ABC 3340 News at 4, 5, 6, and 10 o'clock. Thanks for watching. Have a great evening, and God bless.
Summer's just around the corner, and KS Services wants to be the team ensuring your comfort. We repair and install all makes and models, so give us a call today to get a free, no-hassle second opinion.
KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.